Hey yo, so I recently chatted with YouTuber SMQ.AI for OCCULTURE Raw, a bonus feature for $5 plus patrons over at patreon.com/OCCULTURE. SMQ was a guest back in episode 38, where we talked a lot about his We Died in 2012 video series, which focuses on the Mandela effect and the nature of time and reality itself. This time, we chatted a bit more about the Mandela Effect, and I played a bit of a devil's advocate role, and I challenged him a bit more than I usually would on that kind of stuff. Throughout the conversation, we talked about coincidence theory, changes to human anatomy, the work of William Burroughs, critical thinking, and museums on the moon. So this is a clip of that chat. Enjoy.
I went from the Mandela Effect, and now I'm getting into more like this guy, Paul Kramerer. And he committed suicide in 1926 when he was 45, and he wrote this book called The Roots of Coincidence, and I've ordered that, and I'm going to get that. And really what I've been getting into is sort of this synchronicity versus there's coincidence theory, and then there's synchronicities, and I'm trying to get into that and paying attention to signs in my own life, and I've started to journal signs into my life, and I'm trying to connect those things. And I think that one of the episodes I had was when I was 17, I experienced a pretty catastrophic car accident, and I had an NDE during the accident, and I had a collapsed lung, and they had to open me up and had to operate, and it was a whole thing. And apparently I had conversations with people, and I don't remember it because I was probably in shock. And there's a host of explanations for all of those kinds of things, but I noticed that, for instance, because I'm getting into coincidence theory and I'm understanding deeper Jungian synchronicities, how they work, to pay attention to those signs, because they'll teach you and guide you and kind of move you in different ways. And there's sort of a symphony to it. And sure enough, I saw this horrific car accident after I did a show with my co-host, and we were kind of laughing at the Mandela Effect, that the episode before that we were laughing, saying that, you know, now that everyone is concentrating on the moon, you know, we'll probably end up with like a Disney park or something on the moon. And sure enough, we found out that there is a museum actually on the moon, and it comes by a little tablet that has like an Andy Warhol and all kinds of different artists on it that they quote smuggled onto the pod that landed, Apollo, that landed on the moon. And so now there's officially a museum on the moon, and then as we started concentrating on the moon more, there's also now a memorial on the moon that is to all the people who died trying to get to the moon, including the two cosmonauts that died. And we were laughing that, you know, the Mandela Effect, you know, the more you pay attention to something, the more that it gives you, you know, the more that it, like the moon thing, we were on that for a while, and we were making jokes about it, that we weren't taking it seriously, and that it was like sort of this evil or troll-like behavior, like the Mandela Effect was trolling us, and that we joked and called it a satanic Seinfeld, in that it was sort of about nothing, and yet it reminded me of the character Kramer. And you know, I wasn't taking it very seriously, and we were laughing about it on YouTube, so in a very public way. And then the very next day, or actually it was 2 days later, I saw a horrific car accident where I get off on the highway to go to my job, and it really shook me up. And because I was into paying attention to synchronicities and coincidences, I took it as a message personally to me to knock it off. And so I did. And since then, the nature of the observations that I've made have ramped up, and they've changed. So in a way, I feel that not all communication needs to be verbal. Not all communication needs to be visual. There's a very broader form of communication. And this goes back to William Burroughs as well. He wrote, you know, his selected essays in The Adding Machine. You really realize how much of kind of a magician he was, and that he too was working on things like this. And he wrote one of his essays about being a writer, about being he did creative reading, and then he did the technology of writing, and how writing itself can be used to confuse people, particularly if you create words that are meaningless, like communism, materialism, civilization, fascism, reductivism, and mysticism. And he said, through those kinds of compounded words, you can sort of make them mean anything you want in the context of the argument that you're having. And by that, you have sort of a meta dance that's going on in the two warring factions' subconscious. And within that, that's the unspoken conversation that's actually happening. And that usually in our degraded political dialogue, that oftentimes is distilled down into what they call a dog whistle. What a dog whistle is one of the most magical things out there. It's people understanding that there's a meta conversation happening between two people or a person to a group of people. And that conversation happens on the subconscious level. And you all understand that we all had a shared experience. And if I were to construct enough elements of that shared experience, I can speak to you in a way that's indirect, but it's in a way that my shared audience will only understand. And sort of so by reading the work of Burroughs, I'm getting into that sort of shared understanding. But rather than a collection of words, I'm trying to construct my life to understand the collection of events that happen around me. So I'm trying to understand the dog whistle in which the Mandela effect or whatever this entity is that's speaking to me, because I believe it's conscious. And I think I always said from the beginning, and maybe this is why I've gotten deeper into it, the Mandela effect wants your attention. That's why it did pop culture things. The Mandela effect wants to speak to you.